Come out to play, and we'll pretend. certificate. I worked on that one all week. Last night, we played with your favorite band, Die Totenhosen. And they said, watch out, because they're coming here.
Mariana.
We like to play another new song. This song is called Los Angeles is Burning.
Do all you can.
This late stage in Bad Religion's career, we have to say a hearty thank you to all the people of Deutschland, because really this is our home away from home. We've come here so many times, so many years, and many of you were at those shows, so thanks a lot. This is my retirement speech. I thought I'd throw that one in just to see how it goes over, but.
Yeah, not so good, Al.
Well, we gotta do something here. I know that when you come to a big rock party like this, the last thing you wanna talk about is politics. But believe me, if you came from our country, any opportunity is a good one. So, we have a very simple message we'd like to spread throughout the world. And hopefully, if you have some friends in America, you can spread it to them as well. Two simple words. Bush raus! Bush raus! Bush raus! Bush raus! Bush raus! This song's called Recipe for Hate!
Just a recipe.
song called Epiphany. Features Jay Bentley on the electric bass guitar. A new age of reason. Drink cheese and a trick of mine. What good is searching when nothing's there to find? We arrive at this place of no return, my brothers. Only to discover that a man will let us away. So run from the proper truth of who we are. What's right is wrong, what's come is gone, what's clear and pure is not so sure. I'll send this one out to Rock Palast, who have taped us so many times in Deutschland, and we appreciate them so much. Like a rock, like a planet, like a fucking atom bomb, I remain unperturbed by the joy and the madness that I encounter everywhere I turn. I've seen it all along in the books and magazines. Like a twitch before a diet, like a pornographic scene. There's a cloud behind the window. There's a It's a generator. Well, like I said yesterday, it never rains on Bad Religion. Because someone upstairs is a huge Bad Religion fan. Praise God, people! Let me hear you say yeah, y'all. Let me hear you say yeah, y'all. Can I get you to say yeah, y'all? Say Jesus. Can I hear you say Jesus? We'd like to play a song now. This is one of our religious numbers. This song is called Sorrow.
Imagine there will be sorrow. Yeah.
Brooklyn's way to go and punch down. Or when all kings and queens relinquish their crowns. Or when the only true Messiah rescues us from ourselves. It's easy to imagine there will be. Yeah, there will be. One nation, under God. One nation, under God. One nation.
Bad Religion and playing, I mean, there's must be a huge amount of songs that you have in your repertoire. I had the opportunity to have a look on the list what you're playing. How much new material can we hear from the Empire album, Empire Strikes First, and how do you react on the people's or fans' wish for old material?
Well, we, you know, this was the first year where we finally got over 220 songs, and I said to Graffin, we have too many songs, and you can't make everybody happy anymore. If you play 50 songs, someone will still come up to you after the show and say, you didn't play my favorite song. So with that being said, we just kind of throw songs into a hat and pick them out and go, okay, here's what we're playing. It's random and it's fun. There's some songs that you know you're going to play. You'll always play Sorrow. When we come here, we'll always play punk rock song, Digital Boy, Infected. Those are songs that everyone knows us for. The other ones are up for grabs. As far as the new material, we'll play two songs from that tonight. And I think around maybe March, the entire album was available on the internet. So everybody knows the songs already. It's coming out tomorrow or Monday.
For the punk rock bands in America, especially or even for here, was it something that gives them a little bit of new speed just with this Bush administration, that there's coming a more political aspect in the music scene there?
Yeah, I think so. I think we were in the midst of enjoying the happy pop punk where the lyrical content was about your girlfriend or about
cars
or being treated poorly in school, and that's been replaced by some pretty angry people, and not only in punk rock, but just in music in general. I think that's a big statement that musicians of all genres are joining together, saying, "Look, this is not what we want. We certainly don't want to be represented as this. We're, especially musicians that travel outside of America. When you're a band that tours the world, you get to know what people outside of America think of you, and it makes it a lot easier for someone who tours the world to go home and go, you have no idea what's going on out there, but I'm here to tell you, which is why we're going to spend until Election Day on tour in America, talking.